Apollo 1. This was the first crewed mission of the Apollo program, intended to be a low Earth orbit test of the command and service module. It never flew. During a launch rehearsal on January 27, 1967, a cabin fire erupted, killing astronauts Gus Grissom, Ed White, and Roger Chaffee. The disaster was a catastrophic but necessary crucible for NASA. It exposed fatal flaws in the spacecraft's design, including a pure oxygen atmosphere and an inward opening hatch, and forced a complete safety overhaul that ultimately made the Apollo hardware reliable enough to reach the moon. After the fire, NASA made key fixes. They replaced the inward opening hatch with an outward opening quick release hatch that could be opened in seconds. They removed or reduced flammable materials and Velcro inside the cabin and tightened all flammability rules. On the ground, they used a safer nitrogen-oxygen mix instead of pure oxygen. In flight, they kept low-pressure oxygen that was much safer. These changes carried through every later mission and are a big reason Apollo became reliable. Apollo 4. The debut of the moon rocket. This was the first ever all-up flight test of the colossal Saturn V. In a high-stakes gamble, NASA chose to launch the entire three-stage rocket at once, rather than testing each stage individually. The uncrewed mission was a spectacular success. The launch shook the ground for miles, the stages separated flawlessly, and the spacecraft was sent on a high-speed re-entry to simulate a return from the moon. Apollo 4 single-handedly proved that the Saturn V worked and that the path to the moon was powered by a reliable vehicle. Apollo 5. The test of the Spider. This uncrewed mission was the first spaceflight of the lunar module, the ungainly but crucial vehicle designed to land on the moon. Launched into Earth orbit aboard a smaller Saturn 1B rocket, the LM's critical systems were put through their paces. Engineers remotely fired its descent engine to simulate a landing burn and its ascent engine to simulate lifting off from the moon. The mission was a resounding success, proving that the first true spacecraft, designed to operate only in a vacuum, was ready to carry astronauts. Apollo 6. The necessary failure. This was the second and final uncrewed test flight of the Saturn V rocket, and it was plagued with major problems. During ascent, violent pogo oscillations caused structural damage. Two engines on the second stage shut down prematurely, and the third stage failed to reignite in orbit. Despite not meeting its objectives, the flight was mission critical. It exposed dangerous flaws that could have been catastrophic on a crewed launch. The data gathered from these failures allowed engineers to solve the problems, making the rocket safe and reliable for all future Apollo missions. Apollo 7. Commanded by Wally Schirra, it was the first crewed Apollo flight, successfully testing the redesigned command and service module in Earth orbit for 11 days. Its primary objective was to be a full shakedown of the spacecraft that had been grounded since the Apollo 1 fire. The mission was a resounding technical success, proving the CSM was spaceworthy and capable of rendezvous and docking maneuvers. It was the critical first step in clearing the path for lunar missions. Apollo 8. Originally planned as an Earth orbit test, the mission was changed to an ambitious lunar orbit flight. Commanded by Frank Borman, the crew of Apollo 8 became the first human beings to ever leave Earth's gravity, orbit the moon, and witness the far side with their own eyes. Their Christmas Eve broadcast from lunar orbit, featuring the Earthrise photograph, was a profound moment for humanity and a decisive political victory in the space race. The mission proved that navigation to and from the moon was possible. The switch to the moon came late in 1968 because the lunar module wasn't ready. Rather than wait, NASA sent the command module all the way to lunar orbit. The crew performed the first translunar injection, read from Genesis on Christmas Eve, and captured Earthrise, which helped people see our planet in a new way. Apollo 9. The full dress rehearsal in the safety of Earth orbit. This was the first crewed flight of the complete Apollo spacecraft. the Command and Service Module, and the Lunar Module. The crew, commanded by James McDivitt, performed the first-ever docking and undocking of the two vehicles and flew the LM independently for several hours. This mission was a crucial engineering test, proving that the strange-looking lander could function as a self-contained spacecraft and that astronauts could successfully maneuver it. Apollo 10. The final dress rehearsal at the Moon. Commanded by Thomas Stafford, this mission did everything required for a lunar landing except for the landing itself. The crew flew the lunar module, nicknamed Snoopy, down to an altitude of just 9 miles above the lunar surface, scouting the landing site for Apollo 11. It was the final, full-scale verification of all procedures, hardware, and navigation in the lunar environment, confirming that every piece of the puzzle was ready. Apollo 11, the fulfillment of a national goal. Commanded by Neil Armstrong, this was the mission that put the first humans on the moon on July 20, 1969. Armstrong and Buzz Aldrin landed the lunar module Eagle in the Sea of Tranquility, while Michael Collins orbited above in the command module. They spent just over 2 hours outside, collecting samples and deploying scientific experiments. The mission was a singular event in human history, a monumental technological achievement, and the definitive end of the space race. On descent, the computer threw 1201 and 1202 program alarms, but it kept running, and Armstrong took more manual control to steer past a boulder field. They touched down with only seconds of fuel left, which adds real tension to the story. Apollo 12. The mission of pinpoint precision. The second lunar landing, commanded by Pete Conrad, had a key objective: to prove that Apollo could land at a specific target. The crew successfully set the lunar module Intrepid down just 600 feet from Surveyor 3, a robotic probe that had landed 2 years earlier. They retrieved parts from the probe for analysis and conducted 2 moonwalks, demonstrating that Apollo was not just a proof of concept, but a reliable tool for scientific exploration. Right after liftoff, the rocket was hit by 2 lightning strikes. Telemetry went crazy until the famous call SCE to AUX brought the systems back. On the moon, their color TV camera got ruined when it was pointed at the sun. Even with those issues, the landing was razor accurate, and bringing home Surveyor 3 parts showed how precise and reusable Apollo techniques could be. Apollo 13, the successful failure. Commanded by Jim Lovell, this was intended to be the third lunar landing. 2 days into the mission, an oxygen tank exploded, crippling the service module and forcing the crew to abandon their lunar objective. The mission instantly became a desperate rescue operation. Using the lunar module as a lifeboat, the astronauts and mission control worked together to overcome one crisis after another to bring the crew safely back to Earth. It became NASA's finest hour, a testament to human ingenuity under pressure. They had rising CO2 because the command module's square filters didn't fit the lunar module's round system. Mission Control walked the crew through building a boxy adapter from tape, a plastic bag, cardboard from the flight plan, and suit hoses. It looked like a little mailbox, it worked, and it kept the air safe. Apollo 14. The restoration of confidence. After the near disaster of Apollo 13, this mission, commanded by Alan Shepard, who was the first American in space, had to be perfect. Its objective was to successfully land at the Fra Mauro Formation, the original target for Apollo 13. The mission succeeded, restoring faith in the Apollo hardware. Shepard famously hit 2 golf balls on the lunar surface, but more importantly, the mission resumed the scientific exploration of the moon. Apollo 15, the dawn of true scientific exploration. This was the first of the J missions, longer and more ambitious flights focused on deep science. Commanded by David Scott, it was the first mission to carry and use the lunar roving vehicle. This car-like rover allowed the astronauts to travel miles from their landing site at the Hadley Rill, transforming them from local surveyors into true field geologists. It represented a major upgrade in the program's scientific capability. They found the famous Genesis rock, a light-colored anorthosite that likely came from the moon's early crust. Command Module pilot Al Warden performed the first deep space EVA to grab film canisters from the sim bay, literally a spacewalk between Earth and Moon. On splashdown, one parachute failed, but the capsule was designed to land safely with two, which it did. Apollo 16. The mission to the Lunar Highlands. Commanded by John Young, this flight targeted the Descartes Highlands, a region believed to be formed by ancient volcanic activity. Using the lunar rover, the astronauts conducted extensive geological surveys, but the rocks they collected proved the area was not volcanic at all, but was instead shaped by meteorite impacts. The mission was a prime example of scientific discovery, where sending human geologists to the surface overturned a major, long-held theory. Also, a concern with the service propulsion system engine delayed the landing until engineers were confident it was safe. The crew left a far ultraviolet camera on the surface to study space from the moon. They also deployed a small subsatellite from the command module. It decayed earlier than planned, but still returned useful data. Apollo 17, the grand finale. Commanded by Gene Cernan, this was the final mission of the Apollo program. It was the only mission to carry a professional scientist, geologist Harrison Jack Schmidt, and was the most scientifically productive of all the landings. They explored the Taurus-Littrow Valley, discovered orange soil of volcanic origin, and spent over 3 days on the surface. Cernan, the last man to step off the lunar surface, left with a promise that humanity would one day return. Highlights include the only night launch of a Saturn V, lighting up Florida like day. Schmidt's find of bright orange soil at Shorty Crater turned out to be ancient volcanic glass beads, a strong sign of the moon's fiery past. Three long EVAs, long rover drives, and heavy sample loads made this the science peak of Apollo. Thanks for watching. What do you think the next chapter of lunar exploration will look like? Let me know in the comments. Also, remember to like and subscribe if you enjoyed this video.